Hello and welcome to RPG Maker Tips and Tricks for Beginners. Let's get right into it. Number 1. RPG Maker Entries Dark Mode. You can activate the Dark Mode under Tools, Options, and here under UI, you can pick a theme, including Dark Mode. Number 2. Inside the Event Editor, you can simply select the command and hit Space to open up its properties. If you want to close and save, hit Control Space. Number 3. You can use comments to structure your events. This will make it easier to navigate them. Plus, it will help to remind you what you did when you look again at your projects weeks later. For example, let's say you have a massive cutscene, and this might help you to find a certain part of that cutscene when you search for it. For example, something like villain enters the scene. Number 4. Organize your plugin manager. Go into your plugins folder, right click, new TXT file, name it something like --graphics --. Put the ending to a JS, and you can use it within your plugin manager. Remember to turn it off, since there's no content in it. Number 5. You can use the event search to check where a variable or a switch was used. This can be very helpful for debugging. Number 6. You can have more than 16 faces on one face set. Just double or triple the height of a file. Two rows of faces always have the height of 288, so you can just add that to the height. But I wouldn't go overboard with it. Maybe stick to a height of 6 rows or something, as a big file takes longer to load. Number 7. While in player test mode, you can hit F9 to exit the switches and variables, which you also can set from here. The values you set here won't be saved, they are just for playtest. Number 8. Debugging or cheat NPCs. You can create a new event, give it a very recognizable sprite, for example, a bright pink square, and when you talk to it, have it set a lot of variables or switches or give you items, so you can skip past certain points of your game and, for example, only test the area that you're currently working on. Remember to set the sprite to something that feels very out of place, simply so you don't forget to delete them later on. Number 9. Walking through collisions in playtest mode. When you hold down control, you can walk through collisions in playtest mode. Number 10. Wait commands. For RPG Maker MV, 60 frames equals a second, so you can use this to get a better feeling for your wait commands. Number 11. Custom fade in and fade out durations. I put the script calls for these on the screen. Number 12. Having your mouse hover over the text input of a message window will give you a pop-up which shows you a lot of commands you can use in your text. For example, a variable. Number 13. During playtest mode, you can hold down either enter or space to speed up events. For example, during cutscenes. This will speed up messages and also make movements faster. Number 14. When working on maps, you can use right-click to copy a tile. Or even a whole area if you hold down right-click and drag your mouse to create a square which it will now copy. Also, you can hold down shift if you only want to use the middle part of an auto tile, for example the center of a floor or wall tile. Number 15. If you want to shift over a whole map, you can do so by doing right click on that map, go to shift and select your x and y values, meaning how many tiles it should move in x or y direction. And that's all I have for now. It's everything I could think of. I hope some of these were helpful. A like, comment or subscribe would be much appreciated. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye!